Welcome to the Happiness Alchemy Podcast. I'm your host, Tracy Goody. Stay with me for expansion, activation, and awareness on your spiritual journey through life and business. Seven components of shifting anything in your life or business. So when you want to break free of old patterns and create something new and wonderful for yourself, there's a few components that go into making that transformation happen on a conscious level. So we can get so addicted to ways of thinking and feeling that until we disrupt the pattern with these components, we may find ourselves feeling stuck and not quite sure why things aren't moving forward or why things are not shifting. But whenever these seven components are working together, shifts absolutely happen. So I'm going to talk about the seven shifts. And then in the coming weeks and months, I want to explore them a little bit deeper. And I want to challenge you to really get to a place where you're practicing these and you're mastering these so you can create that real transformation for yourself this year. Component number one is intention. So most of us are aware of this basic first step. When you want to shift something, it's beneficial to ask, what do I want? How do I want to feel instead of how I feel now? So it's not always the case that we know exactly what we want in our life, but we just know we want something to shift. And so when that's the case, it is beneficial to focus on the emotion that you want to feel instead. So if you're feeling frustrated, you're feeling stuck, or you're feeling a lot of doubt, then you know the emotion that you want to feel might be freedom, it might be excitement, it might be expansion, it might be clarity. So just focusing on the feelings, even if you don't know exactly what it is you want to bring into your life. So you're just asking yourself, what do I see in my life instead of what I see now? So you're just kind of taking some time and tuning in. And again, all of these things are connecting in with your intuition, connecting into your heart. This is where journaling, vision boarding, and things like that really come into play. This number one component is intention. And then you're moving on to acceptance and awareness of what's going on right now. We don't have to like what's going on right now in order to accept it. And what I mean by accept it is you're just at a place of peace around it. When you're feeling really frantic, a lot of anxiety, a lot of depression about what's going on right now, it's tricky to move out of it. But whenever we move into this state of acceptance around what's going on right now, the faster we can move out of it and we can come to a place of peace about our current circumstances. Whenever we have this sense of peace around our current circumstance, we can shift away from it. But whenever we're kind of thinking about it all the time and we're really focused on it and feeling a lot of resistance and a lot of kind of contracted energy around it, it's really tricky to shift out of it. When we resist, we get caught up in what's going on and we can stay in the same loop for years. So awareness of where you're at right now is your first step, and then moving to a place of acceptance in order to let go of this old skin and begin to see the path with clarity to your transformation. So again, just first understanding where you're at, and this works for all manner of different things. This works for relationships, for money, for anything that you can think of. Aware of where you are and then bringing this sense of peace and acceptance of where you're at right now as a step to be moving forward and transforming. Component number three is a dedicated focus. So I would call this mindfulness. And this is the component that I'm going to focus on first. So I'm going to have a 7-day mindfulness challenge coming up here. I'll talk about that a little bit at the end of the podcast too. But in order to shift something into something that feels better, we need to get into the habit of choosing the best feeling thought and emotion we have available. So if you're in a dark place, you don't have to jump all the way to joyful celebration. Just get any better feeling thought or emotion. That is progress. Anything that feels just a little bit better. Choosing and dedicating yourself to reaching for the best feeling thought is going to help to raise your vibration to the place where you can allow your perception to take in the next best steps. Whenever we are stuck in this kind of this groove, this addiction to a certain way of limiting thinking, we can't see the path. We don't have that in our perception. So in order to actually see the path forward, you'll need to raise up your vibration. And you can do that just by choosing a thought that feels slightly better and slightly better and slightly better. And you continue to do that until you are elevated enough to see this path. So whenever you can see this next path, then you start to get into this energy of hope. And then that starts to turn to faith. And then that turns to confidence and security. And then finally, it brings this transformation to fruition. So keeping your dedicated focused, at least for a part of the day, on what you want to bring into your life, not only feels good, but it supports your transformation. And it is going to take effort. And that's why mindfulness is the first component that I really want to focus on and challenge people for 7 days to just begin to practice and work with their mindfulness so that they are aware of it. Component number 4 is connection. So we must be willing to connect above, below, and all around us to bring all the parts and pieces together to create the shift. When we're connected to the earth and grounded, we welcome in focus and peace. When we have connection above, we welcome in clarity and divine support. And when we're connected all around to the people who uplift, inspire, and bring us joy, we are setting ourselves up for opportunities and helpers that are going to guide the way. It's nearly impossible to sit alone on an island and just focus on what we want and have it come to fruition. We need connection so that we are reminded that we are part of a much bigger picture, and we have all of these outside influences and support always available. Sometimes when we're trying to reach a goal, we can kind of isolate ourselves, feeling like we need to do everything on our own. But whenever you're just kind of open to the connection, you'll see that the amount of support you have will propel you forward much easier than trying to force and do things on your own. Component number 5 is a daily reminder. So I would call this mindset. So a daily check-in with yourself and just asking. So this one works very much with mindfulness, but I do consider it slightly different, because with this one, you are doing, you're doing kind of some editing. So you can be shifting your energy on this daily reminder mindset component. So you're checking in with yourself, asking, how are you feeling? Where am I feeling resistance? Where am I feeling great? Where are things really feeling the flow? And then as you're doing that, clearing resistance. So anyone that's listening to this podcast will likely have some experience with some type of energy shifting work. So EFT tapping, shamanic journeying, some type of meditation, some type of energy healing, something to shift that resistance away. So that whenever you are tuning in your daily mindset and asking, how am I feeling? When you find this heaviness coming up, you're able to release that a little bit and then refocus on that which you desire to bring into your life, and then pull in that gratitude and connection. So when you're doing this daily reminder, this mindset, don't be afraid to dive in and say, how am I feeling? And really ask yourself, how am I really feeling about that? Get down to the root of things so that you can be clearing resistance consistently for yourself. But then always remember to end your mindset and your daily reminders off with gratitude and connection, so that you're refocusing, you're visualizing, you're allowing yourself to feel the feelings of that which you want to bring into your life. And that really just helps to ground and cement in that. And again, pull all the parts and pieces together. Component number 6 is intuitive action. So as much as others, you know, they might be experts and they might give you some really wonderful advice, when it comes down to it, your own intuitive guidance is going to get you further, faster, in a more flowing, aligned way than anything else. So go ahead and get that guidance from others, but then run it through your filters first. Does this feel like the right path for me? Does this feel like the right time? What's going on? How do I feel about this? Not just blindly following a path that somebody else has laid out for you, because it may have worked wonderfully for them, but maybe not for you. So again, tuning into yourself, your intuitive hits, the more you're tuning in, the more that you're trusting them, the faster they're going to get you to where you want to go. So action steps that are inspired and intuitive always lead to the best miracles. Asking yourself consistently, what can I do today? What can I do this week, this month, this year to align me and move me closer to my desired outcome? Then follow your own advice. You're going to develop a lot more trust and a lot more confidence in your intuition when you follow your advice, and then you start to see the results of that. Or even just pay attention to the times that you don't follow your advice and see how that feels. See what comes up for you then. Often the path is not yet kind of like all the way filled in. So we may not be able to see all the way through. So just trusting that it's the right direction If it feels expansive, if it feels supportive, and if it feels maybe a little bit scary, then you're generally headed in the right direction. As long as you can feel that kind of intuitive connection that this is right for me, even if you have no logical explanation for it, if it feels absolutely right, you feel this magnetic drawing to it, keep moving towards it because there's something really amazing in there for you. And finally, the seventh component is fun. So having fun with the process, laughing, having gratitude, maybe even some tears of happiness along the way at how cool this whole deal is going to speed things right along. Being curious about what is coming up next instead of fearful or worried that, you know, things are not going to come together. It's rare that we can see the whole path now, like I was talking about, but whenever we have this childlike wonder and awe for the journey, and it's more like, oh, I wonder what's around the next bend. I wonder how this is all going to come together. I wonder, you know, how opportunities are going to come together to help bring this to fruition. Whenever we have that energy, we are rewarded with circumstances that make us go, well, that was cool. That was amazing. And accept that you have these cycles where it's not always time for this fast-paced action. Don't take things so heavy and serious that you will, you're not going to be able to flow whenever it comes time to be inspired and be moving forward if you're in that energy of nothing's working, nothing's working, nothing's working, I don't feel inspired to do anything. But whenever you come back to, what cycle am I in right now? What feels good to me right now? And coming back to that energy of joy and fun, and you're just asking yourself, well, what feels really good to me right now? Your cycles are always going to move you through and move you to your goal and to the thing that you want to bring to fruition. So again, don't get caught up in these obstacles. Just visualize yourself flowing like water, where whenever things come up, because obstacles are going to come up, you can flow around it and not get totally derailed by it. So once you're done with those seven components, it's about repeating them. So like I mentioned, I'm going to offer a series of challenges. So first up is the 7-day mindfulness challenge. And this is going to help to get you to a place of awareness and reconnect to yourself. And this is really crucial as you are wanting to create transformation in your life. So I'm going to post the link to sign up for that free mindfulness challenge in the show notes below. I would love to have you join me. It's going to be 7 days. Some really simple steps, but some really good basics to get you aligned to mindfulness that helps to create transformation. So I hope you will join me for that. And thank you so much for listening today.